he is here with us. We have Good Friday and Easter where he tells us to go and to give that gift to others. That good news. And the next time we ask that question, Lord, why am I here? It is truly in confession. And we confess what we have done to him. This victory he gives to us. For that same fire that we say also, the fire of God's word is in my heart and my bones. He calls me as his own. I cannot contain it. No matter how crudely I mess it up, you've still put me here. He has given us the light of his passion. And we're going to see it through. And even if more darkness were to come upon us, and with all these other news stories and things that are similar, that go on in our lives also, makes us feel that we are more alone than ever before. All the pieces that are just laying around on the ocean floor are very similar to the pieces that lay around us. Even our sacrifices in pursuing what he's asked us to do, those are not going to be missed. God is not going to overlook the spewed implosions and pieces, no matter how small or minute they may be. Just like he counts the hairs on our head, if I have any left. If we lose just one or two, he knows. And God says he's noticed. He sees it all. And you know, we get something today that Jeremiah longed for. A little bit of rest, but also an invitation to the table. This very hour, the divine banquet, where he gives us his body and blood. His full completeness, the entirety of his forgiving us with his compassion, his heart. And we go on even from last week. Remember it said that we are sent out as sheep among wolves. And those are the places that he wants you and I to be. We go not out as a tourist, but the same as the disciples, God puts us there and put us here to be in his presence and to take that to others. And the true faith moves on. And we confess that God has us and we have him. We go where he says, and then unto life everlasting. Amen. May the peace of God, which surpasses all human understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Please arise for the prayer of the church as you are able, as you see fit, in the comfort levels. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. That sin would not reign in our mortal bodies or make us obey its passions, but as those who brought from death unto life, we would present our bodies to God as instruments of righteousness. Let us pray to the Lord. For courage and fortitude, that God would bless his pastors and people to sing his praises, endure suffering for the name of Jesus, and continue by his grace to the end. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the households of this congregation, that our Father in heaven would overcome division with unity of faith, give wisdom and peace where there is anger and strife, and bless parents with faithfulness to teach their children. Let us pray to the Lord. For the authorities of our nation, that God would bless them with wisdom to seek the common good, deliver them from all temptations, and to promote evil and to oppose his will, and give them penitent hearts and confidence in his grace. Let us pray to the Lord. For the love of God's word, that though the word treats it with derision, we would hold fast to the scriptures and declare God's praises. Let us pray to the Lord. For those persecuted for the name of Jesus, that God would look with favor upon them, be the dread warrior against the evil one, and make his mercy known to the world through their suffering. Let us pray to the Lord. For rescue from fear, that he who delivered our souls from death would straighten our faith to walk before him in the light of everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who partake of Holy Communion this day, that they would present themselves as those brought out of death into life, and to receive in repentance the forgiveness of their sins. And Lord, at this moment, I also pray for those who are sick, and those that we name in our hearts to you alone. Let us pray to the Lord. Be merciful to us, O Lord, and hear our prayers. Grant to us the grace of our Holy Spirit, of your Holy Spirit, that we may be led into all truth and be steadfast in the confession of Christ through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. May be seated. may arise. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and everlasting God, for the countless blessings you so freely bestow on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh and laid on him our sins, giving him unto death that we might not die eternally, because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns to all eternity. All who believe in him will overcome sin and death and will rise again to new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, we give thanks to you, our Heavenly Father, for the life and knowledge that you have revealed to us through your Son, Jesus. To you be glory forever. Just as this bread was scattered upon the mountain, as many grains and coming together became one, so also your church comes together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. And just as this cup is made of wine from many grapes, you join us one to another in this holy Christian church, for we are all one bread and one body, even as we are all partakers of this one bread and drink from the one cup. Grant us unity of mind and heart with each other and our Lord Jesus Christ. As we partake of his true body and blood, hear us as we pray in his name, as he has taught us to pray. Our Father. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. This, do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after he had supped, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you, for this cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This ye do as often as you drink of it in remembrance of me." Peace of the Lord be with you now and always. Face me. The true body of Christ Jesus, given up unto death for you for the forgiveness. Please rise. Let us pray to the Lord. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this salutary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith towards you and in fervent love towards one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious unto each and every one of you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. in peace and serve the Lord. Amen. I think we have a couple of announcements close by. Downstairs for... If you'd like to stay for Family Bible Hour, we'll be down in a few minutes. But thank you again for everything today. My name is Pastor Chris from Holy Trinity Burbank, filling in for Hisham. And we thought we'd switch pulpits today and to rest and reflect with you all. So thank you for the opportunity to be with you. Amen.